All right, guys, we are in a place called Dripping Springs, Texas today. It's right outside of Austin, and I'm here to do, well, I think 5 rooms of stretching. There's a closet too. We're gonna take a look at everything first. This particular job, it's not a puzzle to put together. It's quite a bit of work, but it's not a puzzle. Everything is pretty laid out, pretty simple. The rooms are rectangular, which is what you're looking for. Here we go. Start out in a closet. I'm gonna do this guy first. You can see the wrinkle here pretty easy on camera. So right there, and this house, the whole reason why this one's doing this is because for some reason, I don't know, when carpet guys get out in the country outside of town here, they like to lay the carpet down and run. And they know it takes 4 or 5 years for it to wrinkle up, so they're gone. The master bedroom. I don't know if there's more light I can find. There we go. Got wrinkles here and over there. And wrinkles will generally happen, well, they'll pop up in the places that you walk on the most. That will cause carpet to wrinkle too, foot traffic. But that's not why this one's wrinkling. This one's wrinkling because the carpet guys didn't take the time to stretch it. All right, there's this room here. Nice and loose. You won't trip over anything, but if you buy a house this nice, you may as well have the carpet stretched. I'm not gonna be cleaning. I guess a lot of people don't realize that I both clean and repair. Generally, if you find a decent repair guy, you find somebody else to do cleaning. Or if you find a good cleaner, you find a different repair guy. Because you don't find a lot of times really good cleaning and really good repair out of the same person. But that's fine because I don't really have time to clean the thing today. I gotta get back to town and do a carpet clean and a tile clean, and by the time I get done with this, it will be difficult to get back to town in time to do that. So finished up around 11:30 or midnight last night, and I'm trying to get that video loaded up. Basically, on this side of the wall here is where it decided to wrinkle up here, so this room is going that direction. We're gonna go get started in the closet. So I'm gonna cut the camera off and begin because work's never over. I've got the wrinkles pulled out now, and I'm just letting the stretchers hold it right now. And here in a few minutes, I'm going to tuck it in and cut it off, and then move to the master bedroom here. Let's go take a look at the master bedroom. See what my plans are going to be here. I believe I'm going to go that direction with the carpet in here. Yeah, I think that'll work just fine. All right, I'm gonna stretch across the room this way. All right, check back in a minute when I get ready to tuck all this in. I think that's the spot. So thank you. afternoon, a little tighter, and then cut it off. Now to trim them up a fit. Now this much shorter, so I'll leave that right here, and we're going to move to the next room. Alright, let's explain what I'm going to do here. And again, I'm using a short tripod today, so you're going to be at ground level. I'm going to take up the carpet along this side of the wall here, probably to about midways here to this window, and over there, about midways, right under the electrical outlet probably, and then I'm going to stretch it all that way. So when I check back in, all of that will have been done. Update. Let's take a look here. All right, like I said, I think I'm a step ahead. I've actually made the first pull on the carpet here. What was I gonna say? Probably nothing important really. It's going well. The closet, when you install, I don't know what the deal is. Sometimes, you know, when they install a tack strip, you know, the nails will hold just fine. Other times they won't. The closet, I probably put like 5 or 6 nails in the tack strip to hold it. This room, I haven't had to yet. Tack strip's holding just fine. But as I've said in other videos before, if this is something that it happens, generally the fastest way outside, I don't really agree using a ram set, but if you use a hammer drill and you use the 1-inch nails out of the ram set, you can drill a 1/8 hole. It's a 1/8 concrete bit, not masonry, concrete drills better, and you can use these 1-inch ram set bits. ram set nails. Those are meant to be used with a 22 gauge ram set, and it's difficult to get the charge right and the amount of pressure right to put one in without blowing the tack strip completely to pieces. I've had more fails than I have successes using the ram set, so I opt to drill a hole, and it takes a longer to drill a hole and to put the nail through, because when you blow the tack strip all to hell, it takes you a while longer to replace that. So there you go. Slower is faster. Something like that. All right, I'll cut the camera off and do a little more work and check back in shortly. All right, what's been done is everything around the edges has been tucked in. The only thing left to do is to knee kick it in and tuck it and cut it. There's a lot of stuff you gotta leave out for just sheer boredom here with this going on. I couldn't imagine what it'd be like to watch an entire carpet stretching, so just trying to, I guess you could call it highlights of carpet stretching, if that's possible. So, look down this way here, and I will be working this direction. now to cut all that off. See here. I don't think the camera's quite far enough back. Alright, we're gonna start over here. We're gonna start by getting in the way here. This is Corey. Hello? That's me? Yes, I can help you. Yeah, are you calling to schedule a cleaning or repair yourself? Yeah, as far as me getting new customers, I don't know where I'd put them at this point. I'm getting home around midnight, as is. So, I guess keep looking around, man. I'm good here. Thank you very much for the call. Bye bye. Okay, you only heard half the conversation. This is very important here. If you're starting a small business and somebody is calling to sell you advertising, you don't want it. It's junk. The good advertising you have to go out and get. If anybody's calling to sell you advertising, you don't want it. Because if they could look online and find you, then you've done something right. So your customers can find you too. And I'm at the point now where I'm not growing the business. It's just me. So I'm just keeping me busy. So if me paying for someone to send me customers to turn them away makes no sense. Anyway, back to stretching. All right, carpet is now this much shorter on this room here. So I'm gonna go set up at the next room. All right, got a little bit more to go here. There's three rooms left. So we're gonna take a look at the three rooms before I begin. Hoping the master was probably the most difficult to do. It was probably the worse shape for stretching. So these are just rectangles. So let's take a look here. Now this room is going to go that direction. Wrinkles are under the bags here in a few places and right here. Okay, now there's this room still remains here. Not huge wrinkles, but so I'm going to stretch this room this direction. And there's one more room. And this room, the majority of the wrinkling is right at the baseboard. If it weren't for the closet here, I would fix it right there. But I don't really want to cut into the closet so much. So I'm going to stretch it the other way. I'm going to stretch it this way to avoid making a seam. I feel like making a seam right now, so we're going to go that way with it. I'm going to start near the room and update as needed. Okay, I have got it all laid out flat here now. Got all the wrinkles pulled out. So I'm going to go and I'm going to tuck everything in now and then turn it off. So I will catch up here in a minute. Still need a cameraman. All right, I took the liberty of finishing this out. I'm going to show you what I did. You didn't miss anything. This room here, I didn't have to cut anything off whatsoever. Stretched and it tucked just fine, and everything went under the baseboard. So nothing really to report here that much. So now we go next door, right here, to this room. And this one looks looser than that one. So I'm saying I'll definitely get maybe a quarter inch off this room. The next room, I'm thinking it will all fit under the baseboard. Because the only place that the problem is right here. So I say when I stretch it that way, it'll all fit under the baseboard. So we'll find out. There you are. I stretched it once. I got the tall tripod. Getting ready to move the stretchers over a little bit and stretch it again. So, here we go. All right, now that probably does probably all the stretching that needs to be done here. I'm gonna watch it, see if it looks like I need to move them again, but probably that's gonna get the job done. I'll check back here in a minute. Everything in over here. I just left a little piece to finish out right over here. So we're gonna do that right now. Between the tile and the texture of the doorway. To change out, make sure we got a sharp blade, and it looks like I can flip it over and start over fresh again. Thank you. what I pulled off of here. So we got one more room to go. I'm gonna move the camera next door and start the last room. Hey guys, I'm officially finished with this job here. I didn't show any of this because I'm getting kind of tired, moving kind of slow right now. So I went ahead and finished it out. And I'm gonna show you what I took off here. This one, I took off more than I thought I would. It's, an inch or so. So this room's considerably tighter than it was. And all the wrinkle pulled off the wall here. What was weird was over here, there's a piece of carpet that was just laid in here. And then I realized the tile is funky too. I don't know what was there. I don't know if it was like a doorway was widened or something at some point. I don't know. It beats me. Something going on there. It got both the carpet and the tile. Alright, well, I appreciate you guys watching the videos. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. It helps the channel do better. If you have questions, they're always welcome. Not a problem at all. I wish there were somewhere when I was learning how to do this. I wish there was somewhere I could have went like this to learn and to ask questions. I think I remember calling through the phone book back in 2001 trying to find somebody that could help me understand, you know, how carpet cleaning was done, anything. I found like one guy that would talk to me. Everybody else would either try to sell me something they didn't want or just hang up and be rude. A lot of rudeness in the industry. Not good at all. You know, carpet guys talk bad about each other. You know, if you do something a little different way than what they do, they consider you wrong and them right. There's several ways to get where you're going. Hopefully from watching this channel, I help you better your business a little bit. Main thing is to treat your client right. Always do right by your client. If they're happy with you, you'll always do well because they'll always come back to you. Once you find a good carpet guy, it's like finding a good mechanic. You're going to stick with them. You're not going to try anybody else. You just have to make sure your schedule is open and try to fit your regular clientele in when they call. If they're new, you can let those go. But your regular clientele, when they call, I'll stay out to 2 or 3 a.m. to get them done. All right, I'm going to pack up and drive about a little over an hour across town to do some carpet cleaning and some tile cleaning. I was told it's supposed to be a small job. So we'll see when I get there. All right, guys, I sure appreciate you watching. If you have questions, please text 512-350-1129. Again, Corey Thibodeau, CarpetMuscle.com in Austin, Texas.